the other side of this lovely 10-inch 80 RPM, not 78 RPM, shellac record, a Columbia record, Puss in Boots. The story was by, or the fairy tale by Herbert C. Rideout, and it's told by Bransby Williams with effects.
Feel you want to be unkind to Pussy, always remember the story of Puss in Boots. Long, long ago, there lived a farmer, and to his youngest son, he left a cat.
Meow-wow.
Now, Puss was no ordinary cat. She wore boots, and when she put these on, she could make her master understand when she spoke to him. So when she saw him looking sorrowful, she pulled on her boots and said,
Meow-wow.
Cheer up, master. Let us seek our fortune. And Puss stole quietly into the forest while her master slept and surprised a big rabbit and caught it and took it and laid it down before the king with a
meow, wow.
This fine rabbit I present with my master's compliments. And the king gave Puss a purse of gold. The next day, Puss and her master were passing a deep pond, and Puss heard the sound of hunting horns and the jingle of horses' bells, and saw the king and his nobles coming that way.
Meow, wow,
said Puss. Quick, jump into this pond, my master. And as the king drew near, Puss shouted,
Help, help, meow, wow, help. Who will save my master? Meow, wow!
Then the king recognized Puss as the clever cat and bade his followers rescue the young man and carried Puss and his master off to the palace. But the king was very sad, for a big, ugly giant who lived nearby was terrifying his people.
Meow, wow, wow,
said Puss. I'll rid your majesty of this wicked giant.
Wow, wow.
And Puss went to the castle and sat and laughed at the giant.
Meow, wow.
You pretend to be a magic giant. You couldn't turn yourself into a rat.
Meow, wow.
The giant looked fierce and growled. Couldn't I? Just you watch. And the giant changed himself into a fine fat rat and plump. Came down the paw and killed the rat, and Puss gobbled him all up. The king was so pleased that he asked the cat to name his own reward. Puss replied,
Meow, wow!
Create my master a marquis, give him riches, and the princess for a wife. Gladly the king promised and gave Puss and his master all they asked.
Meow, wow!
What's the matter, Puss? Didn't I finish the story? Why, of course, the Marquis and his princess lived happily ever after, and Puss became the most famous cat in all the world. Didn't she, Puss?
Meow, wow!